good afternoon. I want to welcome you to the next in our series of webinars presented by CUES. My name is Craig Gleckler, and I'm the marketing manager at CUES. I'll also be your host for today. Today's topic will be on our CUES GraniteNet Infrastructure Inspection and Decision Support Software. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce our speaker for today's presentation, Mr. Edwin Esperanza. Edwin, take it away.
Thank you, Craig. Hi, welcome everybody. So yes, my name is Edwin Esperanza. I am a technical sales consultant here at the CUES software division. Some background information on me. I have an IT background, been working with IT systems and computers and other tech for about a little over 8 years now. Just recently got my AWS Cloud Practitioner certification, and I've been with CUES for a little over 4 years. Just responsible for providing creative software solutions to our different types of customers. Prior to CUES, I used to work as an IT specialist for a managed service provider in Chicago, and I also study at Lake Forest College, and I have a bachelor's degree in sociology and anthropology. Thank you for that great introduction, Craig, and huge thanks and welcome to everyone in attendance today and all of you who have joined. We really appreciate your support. Without you, none of this will be possible. I hope you find the information I share with you today useful, and I'm able to shed some light into what our GraniteNet software and CUES as a whole has to offer. To start it off, I'd like to share some information about CUES. CUES was founded in 1964, making us the oldest and largest manufacturer of CCTV inspection and rehab equipment in the world. For over 50 years, CUES has provided innovative pipeline infrastructure, inspection technology, and equipment to global water and wastewater industries. Some of the tools we provide to collect data are pan and tilt cams, small push cams, pole cams, sonar systems, radar sensors, and honestly, the list goes on. Not only that, but we've also been designing software for over 2 decades. We're the only manufacturer in the U.S. that offers both hardware and software under the same roof, which makes it super convenient when collaborating in new ideas and innovations. CUES is a true one-stop shop with our worldwide headquarters located in beautiful Orlando, Florida, very near to the theme parks, malls, other attractions, so you guys should definitely come pay us a visit sometime. We'll give you a tour. We also have 8 other service centers spread across the USA, Canada, and the UK. As of right now, CUES has over 10,000 systems installed worldwide. So we've been doing this for a very long time. I'm not saying we're the best at what we do, I'll let you be the judge of that, but we're very well established. Today, I'll be providing a high-level overview of our GraniteNet software and some of the features available within our platform. We won't be getting too deep into the weeds, but I'm hoping that by the end of this presentation, you'll at least have a better understanding of what GraniteNet is and how it can benefit you and your team, what our two unique user interfaces look like, and how to navigate each one. You'll also learn about our third-party integrations and some of the ways those can be used to facilitate your workflow and decision-making process. We'll explore some of our latest specialized tech, such as WebGPS and WebRTC, and lastly, discuss some of the customizable options within the GraniteNet platform. You'll also have the opportunity to ask questions at the end of the presentation, so have those ready because we got answers. I mean, I might not, but I know someone who definitely does. All right, without further ado, let's jump right into it. What is GraniteNet? GraniteNet, or GNet for short, is our current core software platform, and like fine wine, it's only getting better with time. We have an amazing development team working around the clock on improving the software and making it more intuitive and versatile to meet the growing needs of the industry. GNet is the next generation of our highly successful Granite XP software and has been architected using contemporary technologies offering unmatched flexibility, customization, and ease of use. Our platform provides a complete software solution for managing the condition of your assets. GNet's ability to provide a unified view of the current condition of a particular asset is made possible by a process called data fusion. where it syncs all of the data being collected against an asset while also retaining the asset's history all under one single database. This also allows your decision makers to triage the assets in your infrastructure to determine remaining useful life, infer risk, and make more informed decisions. The software is now also capable of providing repair and rehab suggestions based on the defects being collected, but I'm getting ahead of myself. We'll discuss that later in the presentation. Okay, now that you have a basic understanding of what GraniteNet is, I think we can go over our user interfaces. First up, GraniteNet Basic. GraniteNet Basic is our inspection and data collection user interface. It is designed for CCTV and field operators to optimize the data collection process. When you hear the word basic, you may think it's a limited version of the software, but that's not the case at all. Basic refers to the simple and easy to use interface, which can also be used on smaller screens and portable devices. Given that basic was designed with the operators in mind, we wanted to allow for quick data entry and easy report generation. So we built an intuitive and user-friendly interface that provides just that. All in all, GraniteNet Basic is streamlined for the folks out in the field and provides your CCTV operators with all of the tools they need to quickly and efficiently collect any type of data in the field. We also wrote our user guide and help manual into the software to facilitate with training and troubleshooting. It can also help answer questions that come up while out in the field. Next, we'll see what the GraniteNet Basic interface looks like during the inspection process. All right. The image on the screen is a snapshot of our GraniteNet Basic interface. We're currently looking at the mainline inspection layout. As you can see, the layout has four main panes, and each one displays a different set of data. On the top left of the screen, we can see where we can start a new inspection, which is the green play button. And right next to that toolbar, we have our mainline inspection form, where your operators can easily navigate the form and enter inspection details prior to starting the inspection. Right underneath that inspection form, we have our inspection observation list. This is where GraniteNet keeps all of the observations that were collected during the inspection. Your operators can simply click on the new observation button to create observations for your defects. On the top right of the screen, we have our video recording and video playback pane. This is where they'll be able to record the inspection video during the inspection and also watch the video playback once the inspection has been completed. This pane can also be used to record sonar data as well, if available. Lastly, the bottom right corner of the screen shows the collected data gallery. This is where GNet keeps all of the pictures and videos captured during the inspection. You're also able to add reports and any other items that pertain to the inspection using our media linking module. As I mentioned before, GNet Basic is streamlined for your operators to optimize data collection. Now we'll move into our other interface, which is GraniteNet Advanced. All right. As important as it is to have your operators collect data quickly and efficiently, being able to quickly analyze and make decisions with the data being collected is just as crucial. GraniteNet Advanced provides users in the office with the ideal interface for reviewing the completed inspections coming from the field. GraniteNet Advanced is oftentimes a bit of a familiar surprise for folks who have worked with our Granite XP software in the past. The GNet Advanced interface resembles Granite XP for several reasons. One of them being that it makes it for a much more easier transition for Granite XP users when upgrading to GraniteNet, because there's no need to relearn the software all over again. It looks almost exactly like it. It is a much more sophisticated interface that provides you with a bigger workbench, since you're able to arrange your layout to your liking and move panes across multiple monitors, which is perfect when reviewing data in the office. This doesn't mean that GraniteNet Advanced can't be used in the field. On the contrary, operators using GraniteNet Advanced are able to make informed decisions out in the field, since they're able to quickly access full inspection details and historical data with the click of a button. always easier to make decisions when you can see the bigger picture. Yes, GraniteNet is a bit more sophisticated than BASIC, but you don't necessarily need a college degree to work within the software. The advanced interface is super user-friendly and can be customized to fit your role, needs, and preferences. Next, I'll show you what the GraniteNet Advanced interface looks like. So, GraniteNet Advanced for data analysis. Honestly, the best way to describe this image is bigger picture. You still have the four panes similar to the basic interface, but they're just arranged differently. GraniteNet Advanced provides a much more flexible layout, allowing you to move panes around the screen easily so you can have all the information you need right in front of you. I understand not everyone has a huge screen or multiple displays. As you can see on the image, there are additional tabs located at the bottom of each pane. These tabs include additional details regarding the assets, tasks, inspections, and observations. With the ESRI integration, you can also have your ArcGIS map at its map view, allowing you to work directly off your map. And here I go again, getting ahead of myself. All in all, panes can be tapped to facilitate the review process in smaller screens. Also, every observation created by operators in the field will be linked to its frame within the video, which is a great feature to have when reviewing videos in the office. Let's be honest, no one wants to sit through hours of raw sewer footage. And then also, GraniteNet Advanced can be used for the QA/QC process. As you can see here, the interface design and built-in review process allows for quick and efficient analysis. It completely takes the guessing game out of the equation because you can actually have your asset right next to the inspection form, and the asset form includes everything that's currently in the database, while the inspection form includes everything that was collected by your operator. So you can have a side-by-side comparison between the asset and the inspection, and then you can decide whether or not you want to accept the changes made in the field or you want to reject those changes. So far, we've covered our one platform, which is GraniteNet, and our two unique interfaces, basic and advanced. Now I'll be sharing a few details about our third-party integrations and how those work with GraniteNet to provide added functionality while maximizing workflow efficiency. As powerful of a platform as GraniteNet is on its own, we knew that creating a complete solution wasn't something we could do on our own, not in a timely manner at least. We knew that in order to meet the growing needs of this industry and ensure that our developers got a decent 5 hours of sleep every night, we needed to partner up with some of the heavy hitters in the industry. So we did exactly that. And as you can see on the image, I know on the left side, I have the bidirectional work order management systems, and it only names CityWorks, Info-IPS, and IBM Maximo. But that is because those are the ones that we've shared APIs with. And Beehive and Lucidy, which are on the image, they have tools that are able to import data on their side, or they can read data off our database, but there's no APIs involved, so it's not a bidirectional management system that we support. First up on the third-party integration is ESRI. I don't know if it's my love for archaeology and geolocation, but I've always found GIS fascinating. ESRI's GIS mapping software is the most powerful mapping and spatial analytics technology available, so it only made sense for us to share APIs and bring a full integration to GraniteNet. Being fully integrated means that we can transfer data between the two platforms, keeping both systems fully synchronized at all times. I've been working with GraniteNet for a couple of years now, and can honestly say that this is one of the most powerful integrations within the software, but not only because of what it's capable of, but also because it benefits multiple personnel and departments within your organization. As you can see in the image, you'd have full access to your ArcGIS map within GraniteNet via the map view pane. This allows you to use the map to schedule future jobs, easily color code your lines to visualize risk, and quickly run reports that pertain to a specific criteria. Our dynamic layers are essentially filters that can be applied to the map to search for specific assets, attributes, inspections, and pretty much anything else you're looking for. Throw away those paper maps and highlighters. The software will color code your lines any color you like. And also, you can have a link to your Google Maps. You just select the asset and just have GraniteNet direct you to that location. Next up, we have our third-party bidirectional work order integrations, which would be CityWorks, Maximo, and Infor Public Sector, or IPS. This is where we maximize workflow efficiency because instead of working out of two different platforms, you can have GraniteNet communicating data back and forth between your work order system and your field units. The best part of it all is that you don't really have to do much as a user. The whole process can be automated via the GraniteNet scheduler, which is basically a digital calendar that runs at a specified time and frequency. As part of the implementation process, we would help design the process flow and configure the connections between GraniteNet and your work order system to ensure high efficiency and full synchronization. You're all probably thinking, this is all great info, but how does it actually work? Well, I can show you better than I can tell you. But I'll still tell you. So hopefully everyone can see my cursor here. So this is a general work order integration scenario. We have our work order system server on the left side here. And we have our GIS database also on the left side. And as you can see by the arrow, those are communicating with one another. So those IDs should be linked. They should have the same IDs for your assets on both systems. The way we use the Esri integration is we use it to import the assets and attributes into our GraniteNet database so that all three systems are speaking the same language. As part of the integration, the GraniteNet scheduler, once the work orders are created in the work order system, imports those work orders as pending tasks to our GraniteNet database, which can then be exported to each of the trucks as pending tasks. So now all systems should have the same work orders across the board. So your truck goes out, they go and complete those inspections, bring those back into the office, and we sync with the GraniteNet office database. At that point, the scheduler, whenever it's set to run, will export those completed tasks, and you can also update your work order status on your work order system via the scheduler. And then this person in the middle here has the most important job of reviewing the results and making sure that everything is working as designed. The red arrow here at the top means that if your truck has internet access and they have access to your work order system, they can actually log into the work order system and pull those work orders right from there and create those as pending tasks in GraniteNet. So as part of the integration, we included APIs on their end, as well as they included their APIs on our end. So you have buttons on the work order system that allow you to interact with the GraniteNet software. And last but certainly not least, we have one of our newer partners, Amazon Web Services, or AWS. When the pandemic hit, we saw social distancing and work from home become new norm, but folks still needed access to the resources in the office. This meant they needed to depend on their IT department to provide them with the access to the network from a work laptop or their home PC. Oftentimes, there's security concerns with those network changes, and the IT personnel may not allow it or be skeptical about it. But we partnered with AWS to bring our customers to GraniteNet Cloud, which enables you to work from pretty much anywhere as long as you have a stable internet connection. AWS boasts a 99.5% monthly uptime for the cloud instances. So as long as you're able to access AWS, you'll be able to access your GraniteNet application and web products. Also, once the data hits the cloud, it's secure. We run nightly backups on the data and instance as a whole, so we can always revert back to a previous image if anything was to happen to the data or web apps. We also manage and monitor the AWS instance around the clock, so you'll always be the first to know when there's a problem. Since we have access to the instance, we can serve as a secondary IT consultant that focuses on the cloud instance and GraniteNet applications. Here are some images of the cloud. I mean, there's not much to really show since it all, no one really knows what the cloud is. We just talk about it. But you can securely access the cloud using AWS Cognito or multi-factor authentication. We will also be supporting SSO and other types of authentication on the Gina cloud soon as well. And I guess I can speak to the image that is on the right side here with the trucks. So the way it works, the trucks will stay local. They'll still have their databases. And the little swirl you see here with the arrows is our web sync application. And that's how they communicate with the cloud. This blue square here or rectangle is technically the cloud. As you can see, GraniteNet application will be on the cloud. Your Esri APIs would also be hosted on the cloud, and your media can also be stored on the cloud. So we use the cloud for both hosting and computing. The people in the office, you have two options to access the cloud. For your admin or editable clients, they'll be using AppStream. That's how you'll be able to access the cloud and make changes to the data. For anyone else who needs just viewer access, those users will be using WebOffice, which is our web viewer that can be accessed pretty much anywhere on any device. And then the little guys that kind of got cut off there, they're using WebInspect. That is our, again, one of our newer web apps that allows you to perform any single point asset inspections, cleaning tasks, and also capture GPS coordinates directly from your mobile device. Up next, we have our latest specialized tech. These are the latest software offerings we've released for use with the GraniteNet software and web products. First one on the list, the streaming video recording module. The streaming video recording module allows you to record video being streamed from our QZ3 camera within the GraniteNet software. Instead of recording video on the QZ3, exporting it to a USB or SD card, and then importing it into Granite, you can record it directly from the GraniteNet software as you're filling out the inspection form and entering observations. You're also able to control the camera's focus, zoom, and lights from the software as well. Next, we have the Web GPS module. The Web GPS module was released on our latest version of GraniteNet, which is version 5.5.0, and it essentially turns your mobile device into a GPS receiver. The mobile device linked to your GraniteNet application, or the mobile device is linked to your GraniteNet application, similar to how you'd connect your phone to a Bluetooth device. And once the mobile device begins to stream the GPS coordinates, the coordinates will be transmitted directly to your GraniteNet application. I actually had the opportunity to see this used in the field with those new Trimble Catalyst DA2 devices, and it works like a charm. We were able to get sub-meter accuracy consistently throughout the day. Fortunately, this level of accuracy is currently only available on Android devices, but we hope support for iOS devices will come in the near future. Okay, WebRTC. The RTC in WebRTC stands for real-time connection. WebRTC is not necessarily a module, but it is a new feature available within our WebInspect application and can be used in conjunction with WebGPS to capture GPS coordinates. Similar to our streaming video recording module, the WebRTC feature allows you to record streaming video from a C540, C550, or the PurePoint P540, P550 directly to our WebInspect app. I didn't really get a chance to cover our web products in this presentation, but if you'd like to learn more about those, you should definitely check out the webinar my colleague Nino Rivas recorded, which covers Gina's new leading technology. There's a lot of great information in that video. Prescriptive planning. This one is huge. This tool has been a long time in the making, and it's so great to finally see it in action. Prescriptive planning is a decision support tool that provides repair and rehab recommendations for assets based on the defects being collected during inspections. I mean, yes, you can still have engineers analyze the data and make decisions on your infrastructure the same way we always have. There's nothing wrong with that at all. But why not let the software reinforce those decisions? The software can analyze hundreds of lines in a matter of seconds and provides recommendations that can be shared with the engineering team to assist in their decision-making process. All right, we built the algorithm into the software so it can be used as is as soon as it's enabled, or we can work with you and your team to build a fully customized decision tree to fit your needs. The image on the left there, it's kind of hard to see, but that's the custom decision tree we would help you build. And once it's up and running, you'll be able to apply those layers to the S3 map within GraniteNet and WebOffice, as you can see on the right there. But in the middle, we have some of the decisions that can be provided by GraniteNet. Speaking of customized solutions, pretty much everything you can think of within the software can be customized for the right price, of course. No, I'm kidding. Most of it is included with your support plan. But honestly, we provide all the tools and guidance necessary for you to fully customize your GraniteNet platform to meet your needs. We can create full custom forms for any out of the norm inspections, such as lift stations, grease traps, hydrants, you name it. We can also create reports that coincide with those types of tasks. Coding standards, we actually have several customers that have created their own custom coding standard based off of our CUES coding standard. As I mentioned with the prescriptive planning decision tree, we can create fully customized formulas and algorithms that provide decision support as data is being fed to the software. Media templates, screen layouts, overlays, pretty much anything you can think of, like I said, you can literally even customize certain icons within the software through the GraniteNet management console. So the power of one platform all boils down to the following. You have one program that's fully customizable and communicates with any and everything you're using from hardware to other software platforms. You have one single database that holds all of your recently collected data as well as historical data, providing you with one historical cache containing all the information collected throughout the years, which all revolves around one central point where all of the data can be easily accessed, quickly analyzed, and efficiently managed. That, along with many other benefits, is what our GraniteNet platform is able to provide.
All right. Thank you, Edwin. That was a great presentation.
Thank you, guys. I appreciate it.
We do want to thank you all for attending today and hope you found value in our presentation. If you have any further questions or would like to talk to someone from CUES regarding our GraniteNet software, please feel free to reach out directly to Edwin. His contact details are on your screen. You can also always visit the CUES website for more information. Once again, thank you all for attending.